Hello and welcome to the second round of the NCAA 2020 virtual tournament. Enjoy.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA tournament. Today's game is between the Florida Gators and the Kansas Jayhawks. And there is the starting lineup for each team.
Wow, Gus, the matchup at center position should be really a good one. Sit back. Definitely two of the more skilled big men in the game tonight. They will be the difference makers.
And let's have a look at the keys to the game for these teams here today.
If they can get these things accomplished, they're going to have a good shot at the win today.
The Jayhawks get control of their possession, and we get going. Moss handles the feed.
Inside.
This guy is really known as a power guy.
When he gets it down deep on the box, this kid can knock it down.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Dump it inside. Shot clock shows 10.
Look at that block! Terrific reaction!
Out of bounds and a change of possession. This layup is definitely worth a second look.
Gotta make those, guys. It's incredibly deflating when you don't.
The Jayhawks now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
And what they do is put it on the deck, creating a pinch, and then find the open guy.
Thanks for joining CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. I'm Gus Johnson alongside Bill Raftery. Turns it over. Lewis receives the ball. Jayhawks now running a zone offense.
The impact very similar to their man-to-man. They find the open guy.
Out on the wing. Jump shot.
Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order.
Out on the right wing. Dials up a long-range shot with no luck. Grabs the board. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. The Jayhawks now running the four around one.
Must be alert on that defensive end because guys get pinned and they can step out and knock down the deep one.
Get it down on the low block. In the lane. Shots off. Bat it up. Shots up. Shots off. Give me that. Looking for a good shot. Fires. He can't get it to go. Pulls down the rebound. Now they work it around the perimeter. Jump shot. 7 minutes left on the game clock. And he can't get the bounce. Shots off. He makes the block. Moss receives the pass. He shoots from the corner and misses.
See the floor. He will get some easy fast breaks.
Entry pass in the paint. Shots off.
See, reacting. How alert, Gus.
They've worked the perimeter. He puts up the tray.
How about that, Gus?
6 minutes left on the game clock. Lock handles the pass. He shoots from the corner. No.
Makes them so competitive on the glass.
Dump it inside. And he lays it up and in. And they burn a timeout. We'll have more NCAA basketball coverage in a moment. And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. Looking for a good shot. 5 minutes left on the game clock. Out on the left wing. He goes for three. Comes up empty from deep.
One shot, Gus. You always want to limit the opposition to one opportunity.
On the wing. Jump shot. Off the mark. Give it here. On the left side. In the lane.
How about that, huh?
They work it around the perimeter. Fires. 4 minutes left on the game clock. We're at the midway point in the first half. And coach, this one is shaping up to be a good one.
Well, these two teams are showing us just how well they match up. With parity at an all-time high, you expect to see these type of games in the tournament. It's a shame that one of these clubs will be out when the final buzzer sounds.
In the post.
Look at that block. Terrific.
decision there. We're at the 3-minute mark. Down on the low block, trying to work it inside. He missed it. On the left side. Jump shot. And we have a change of possession here. Rap, it's been a great team effort for these guys.
It's been great teamwork, Gus. When guys are helping one another out at the defensive end, making that extra pass at the offensive end, it makes for good, fun basketball.
In the lane. He can't get it to go. Gets the rebound. They would like to get it inside to the low block. Answer. This guy is a complete player in the post.
They like his game because he can play with his back toward the basket and can shoot it from 12 to 15 feet.
Out on the right wing. Heat check time from long range. But he misses his target. 2 minutes left on the game clock. Try to pack it inside. Fires. And he can't get the bounce. On the low block. Jump shot. No. Snatches the board. On the left wing. Up and in. Ha ha! Wow, what a finish on that backdoor feed, coach.
Oh, Gus, it caught the D sleeping a little bit. Nice look and such a strong finish.
Looking for a good shot. One minute left on the game clock. He shoots from the right of the circle.
Perfect.
They've worked the perimeter. In the lane. Off the mark.
Oh, physicality.
On the wing. Fired. He missed it.
I own it.
Entry pass in the paint. In the lane.
Big time dagger.
They work it around the perimeter. He can't get it to go.
Get out and fill.
At the horn. And he can't get the bounce. Up next, the road to the Final Four. Please stay tuned. And a quick look at the team stats for both teams. We can see here how both teams are doing with the keys they identify at the outset. Bill, these kids have battled for one half. They've battled for an entire season in their conference tournaments. Now it's down to who wants it the most. I think we're about to find out.
Well, we've heard it before, Gus. Survive in advance. I'm certain that these teams will come out and do whatever it takes to survive. Nobody wants to be making that long loser's walk to the locker room tonight.
They work it around the perimeter. No. What a rebound. On the left side. In the lane, the sophomore. Now they work it around the perimeter. In the lane, the senior. In the post, in the lane, off the mark, pulls it in. Cup it inside. In the lane. No. Lewis receives the pass.
You might call this Newton's law.
We're at the 8-minute mark. He got it up and in. Lock handles the feed. Jump shot. Can't get it to go. Dotson handles the pass. He puts up the tray. He missed it.
Rebound and run.
Lewis handles the feed. He gets it to fall. On the left side. Seven minutes left on the game clock. The Jayhawks are moving the ball well and are getting contributions from a number of players at both ends of the floor.
As a coach, it's great to see all five guys on the floor working together. That is impressive. That's how you win, and win consistently, Gus. When multiple people contribute, it takes the pressure off your superstar.
He attempts to dribble around the trap, but is unsuccessful.
Tried to beat it, but he couldn't, Gus.
Looking for a good shot. Jump shot. No!
They should look to push it now. A little woo-woo, Gus.
They work it around the perimeter. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy for this guy. On the outside. The junior. What a pass on the backdoor cut.
Get out of my way!
We are at the 6-minute mark. Top of the key. Fires. Shots off. Takes the rebound. Lewis receives the pass. Rise and fight. Shots off.
Oh, physical play.
No! Takes the board. On the left side.
English on it.
We're at the 5-minute mark. down in the low block. He can't get the bucket to fall. Locke takes the feed. In the lane. Shots off.
Look for the outlet.
Moss receives the ball. Jump shot. They're having a tough time hitting from the floor. Out on the right wing.
Fires.
He can't get it to go.
Look to outlet.
We're at the 4-minute mark. Bill, we had a great tournament game going on here in the first half. I don't know what happened here in the second half, but it's not even close anymore.
God, this is a close one, Gus. I think the last few possessions are going to dictate who moves on, who goes home.
Tup it inside. And he's there with the power jam. Moss handles the pass in the lane, and he can't hit the shot. Block on the left side. Jump shot. 3 minutes left on the game clock. Dotson with the ball. Well, Raph, this could go down to the wire.
You've got to love these close ones, Gus. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss. Gus, you've got to love these tight ones. So much on the line here. One wrong move is all it takes. There's no room for error. How about that elevation?
Handles the pass. He misses from long range. On the right side. We are at the 2-minute mark. With 10 to shoot on the shot clock. In the post.
Ooh, what a flush.
A terrific backdoor play on that last trip.
Oh, really caught the D on their heels. A great cut to the rim. A terrific feed for that easy completion.
Foul on the play. You know, Raph, this guy has really elevated his game today.
Because he understands what he can do and what he needs to do. When a team gets a performance like this, they usually are in position to win.
Here's another solid junior, Bill.
Gus, you look at your juniors as third-year players who have been there. And as a coach, you can rely on them for their experience and ability to guide the less experienced players on the team.
They've got him trapped now, Rav.
Look at that trap, Gus. They may have him.
On the wing. He fires from long range. And he buries the three. And we're ready. And we're back. Gus Johnson along with Bill Raftery with you here, ready to inbound after the timeout. The Jayhawks running their zone offense.
Very effective because of the power on the glass. It opens up that opportunity for tips.
Moss on the left side. Misses from long range.
Bang!
1 minute left on the game clock. Lewis handles the feed. And we'll get a change of possession. Inbounds play on the baseline. Way out on the right wing. Drains it. The Jayhawks, and they're in their motion offense, working with four around one.
Well, if you have a big guy that can find people, it really puts a lot of pressure on the D.
Fired. Good. Jump shot. He gets the shot to fall. And we're back, ready to get things going again after the timeout. The Jayhawks working, changing it up against the zone.
And that's what makes them tough to defend. They understand how to take advantage of openings.
And he's fouled.
Seniors are tough to come by these days. When you have a few of them on your roster, it really helps from a coaching standpoint. They know what's expected of them, and they're most likely to deliver.
No doubt about it. And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. With time running out, outside Jay won't go.
It's all about shot selection, Gus. It's so important to take good shots, and not necessarily the shot the defense wants you to take.
Bill, I think the better team won. It's heartbreaking for the other side, but that's the way it goes. Five and advance is the name of the game.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all of the little intangibles we consistently talk about. And that was the difference in this game.
All right, so that's all for now. For the Governor, Bill Raftery, and our entire CBS Sports crew, I'm Gus Johnson saying so long.